Hi guys, welcome back to the PhotoLab 7 series. Today we're going to talk about luminosity masks, and you'll forgive me if I get really excited about this, because luminosity masks are something that's been around in Photoshop for years and years and years, and it is the most powerful control that you're likely to get your hands on. Now, what a luminosity mask is a mask that enables you to mask out pixels based on the luminosity alone. Now, this is totally different from selective tone controls, where you can highlight the highlights, the mid-tones, and the darks. Luminosity masks allow you to be really precise about the degree of masking, and it is just the most brilliant way of isolating tricky things like TV aerials, jagged horizon outlines and buildings, and so on. Absolutely fantastic. Let's see how these work in practice. I thought it'd be useful to look at the problem that luminosity masks are so good at resolving. What we have in this picture here is a succession of ridges rolling back towards the horizon, and you really can't see them because the dynamic range is so small. So we've got a lot of haze, and the difference between the ridges here, here, and here is minute. So your eye just isn't getting drawn into this in quite the way that I'd envisaged it would. So to resolve this, let's turn on the tone curve for a start. That gives us a little bit more definition, but it doesn't really do it. So we'll go to local adjustments and we'll choose luminosity masks, and we'll put a new one in, and we'll just drop the dropper here. And what that does is sample where I dropped the dropper. Now, I can choose a different range from here. This is modelled on the Ansel Adams zone system. So you've got pure black, pure white, mid-grey at number 5, and some tones in between. And we can do this, override that selection. That probably wants to be a little bit, probably more like it, and that's pretty close to where we want to be. So this has picked out this ridge line here, so the only alteration I would make is to bring it out of the foreground. So I'm going to use a hard eraser here and just erase that mask from this area here, all the way up to here. Okay, that's looking good. And I'm just going to drop the exposure ever so slightly, probably quarter of a stop. Let's turn off the mask for a minute. Raise our midtones a little. We want to differentiate it from the thing. Drop our shadows. And dare I say it, let's add a little bit of clear view. Okay, that's looking good. We can see what a nice sharp outline we've got across the ridge top here. Let's go back into the luminosity mask. Now, this is a tip that may be useful to you. I find it easier to turn the colour off here. So I'm going to go to black and white rendering for this next mask. And now I'm looking purely at grayscales. I find it easier to concentrate on the small, very small differences without colour confusing the issue. So let's go back to local adjustments. We'll call this one Valley. That was our first mask. And I'm going to put a new one in, and I'm going to choose this range here. And that's got most of the sky, so I don't think that was quite the intention. So it's come away, that's more like it. So that's 8. I can draw that in here as well. That will free up the sky quite well. Perhaps draw that in a little bit more. And I think I'll just quickly erase this area here. Now, because this is the sort of total distance, I'm not too bothered about any possible spilling over. But this area I am a bit more bothered about, and obviously the front. So let's take this out. Okay. Spot there, and let's just finesse this bit here and see if we can get it away from that front ridge. There we go, that's nice. Good clear selection, this is what we're after. So we go in here and we just drop that a little bit more. Slight adjustment on the midtones, a little bit of clear view. And you can see that we've now got nice clear outlines on these ridges, and we can see them for the most part folding back into the distance. But we're not going to go any further than this because we don't actually want to get rid of the haze. The haze is a natural feature. So I'm going to go back into the color rendering, and that actually looks quite nice. We've got a slight blue cast, but that's natural. That adds to it rather than detracts to it. So I think we've demonstrated with the luminosity mask how well we can pick out these very finicky little skylines. There is no way in a million years that we would have been able to do that with a brush, and that's the main thrust of this particular video. Other things to mention about the luminosity mask: if we go in here, we've got the Ansel Adams model used as a zone system. We've got this that we can use to finesse it. We've got the dropper tool that we can use to sample any particular area. Now, these tools here are associated with each luminosity mask. So I can play around with the colours. I can change the white balance. I could warm this up a little bit. You'll see that effect coming in there. I'm not suggesting that's necessarily the best for this picture, but I'll take that back. We can change contrast, make that a little bit more contrasty. We can play about with selective tones, clear view and exposure. So I've really used exposure and clear view only here, but there's a lot more flexibility in this. And the beauty of it is, as I say, is that all these settings are applied only to this luminosity mask. So if I go back to this one, we've got a completely different range of settings here. So compared to Lumenzia, which is the tool that I've used with Photoshop, this is a much more nuts and bolts, easy to learn implementation. I think that it's a big advantage working with tools that you're already familiar with. So if you've been working with PhotoLab, you will know all of these tools fairly intimately. So it's much easier to get your head around the complexity of luminosity masks. Best practices, I would be say, although we've got a good result with this picture, we're kind of dicing with death because we've got so little detail in the distances, and it's very easy to bring unwelcome artifacts in. So this, I think, is the sweet spot for luminosity masks. I do think that they're very powerful for this type of picture. I've seen other demonstrations where the necessity for having a luminosity mask isn't entirely clear, that you could have achieved the same result with brushes. But my thing is, in landscape photography, you do have these irregular outlines, and luminosity masks are very, very good for dealing with those. Okay, so if you're still with us, thanks for listening. If you've enjoyed the video, please give it a like underneath, and if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. That would be absolutely fantastic. We've got a ton of these videos coming down the line. Thanks very much, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.